What's up, YouTube? Jim Comics here, and I've become quite the super fan of NBC's sitcom Community as of late. The TV show is just so creative, funny, and honestly subverts most expectations of the modern American sitcom. So if you haven't seen already, I'd recommend go checking it out on Netflix right now. And additionally, I have a ranking video of all the 6 seasons of the show on the channel. So go check it out before you watch this video, or I don't know, check it out afterwards. It doesn't really matter to me. But in this video, I'm going to go over the top 10 best celebrity cameos, and I'll define cameos in a second, on Community. And when I say cameos, I don't mean like, oh, it's like an Easter egg thing. I mean like, if you're not part of the main cast and you are a celebrity, you count as a celebrity cameo. I'll spoil one of my entries. For example, John Goodman plays a repeated recurring villain, like sort of villain, on the show. And while he appears on multiple episodes, I think like 6 or 7 episodes, he is sort of a cameo because he's not one of the main characters. He's not one of the core cast. So I'm going to count him as a cameo in this video. So with that rule out of the way, remember to like, subscribe, and comment down below your favorite Community episodes or favorite cameos in Community. And without further ado, let's get started with number 10. And I won't blame you if you haven't heard of this guy, but Tony Hale. And okay, Tony Hale, you probably don't know him from the name, but if you see his face, you'll know who I'm talking about, okay? I remember him very brightly from an Alvin and the Chipmunks movie. I forgot which one it was. It might have been the 4th one. But he was like a villain in one of the Alvin and the Chipmunks movies. And he appears on lots of stuff. I think he was on a Clifford movie that came out last year. A lot of kids stuff. But the point is, he's a pretty prolific actor. And he appeared in Community Season 1 in one of the funniest gags in the show, I'd say. Where Jeff enrolled in a pottery class, and the teacher was very obsessed or like paranoid about people recreating the ghost scene. So yeah, he plays that teacher who's like, no one create the ghost scene or whatever. You know the ghost scene I'm talking about, where like the pottery of 2 people. Yeah. So the point is, he plays a pretty paranoid teacher in the show for 1 episode, but it is quite a lasting impact. It's one of the funniest episodes of the show, and I just love the way that Jeff breaks the one rule he was told not to break by the end of the show. So yeah, Tony Hale, if you don't know who I'm talking about, I might show him on screen right now, or just look him up, because he is quite prolific, and I do recognize his face from a lot of stuff. Coming in at number 9 is Walton Goggins, and I'm going to be completely honest here, I only know him from Ant-Man and the Wasp. He plays that sort of shady business guy or whatever. But yeah, he's a really funny cameo in this show. I think he appears on 1 episode, maybe 2, where spoilers for the show, I warned you to watch it at the beginning. But Pierce Hawthorne, one of the main characters, dies sometime between seasons 4 and 5. And in season 5, Walton Goggins plays the lawyer that Pierce sent to like interrogate his friend to see if they deserve his will and stuff like that. But the point is, Walton Goggins plays like a deadpan serious lawyer the entire episode. But in the after credits of the episode, like the stinger, he appears to be quite funny and silly and drunk. And apparently, he was only keeping the straight man attitude because it was keeping it professional. It was just, it's just a really funny cameo, and a really funny subversion of expectations with that character. And I just can't get that out of my head, the scene where he jumps on top of the table and yells, "Let's get shot!"
Are you guys thinking what I'm thinking? Shot!
Or something like that. It's just hilarious. So yeah, coming in at number 8 is, in a more significant role than these other two, Kumail Nanjiani. And you may know him from recent Eternals fame, as Kingo, I think Kingo. Yeah, Kingo in Eternals. And he plays a villain custodian or whatever in Community seasons 5 and 6, I'm pretty sure. In season 5 or whatever, he's not that much of a threat. He's sort of just one of the custodians. I mean, he's a named custodian, I'll give him that. And while we're here, I'm also going to throw in Nathan Fillion, his boss, because Nathan Fillion's like the leader of the custodians, and there's a really funny scene with him that's not appropriate right now, but I don't want to talk about it. One of his plot lines is really funny and inappropriate. But the point is, Kumail Nanjiani comes back as a villain in season 6. I think one of the last episodes of the show. Possibly like the fourth or third last episode. And it's a sort of James Bond parody, and he plays the James Bond villain in that episode. So yeah, Kumail Nanjiani does a great job here. He's not his normal, usual, typical funny guy, as he always is. Which is weird, considering it's a sitcom. But he does a great job at playing a villainous character. So that's why he's on this list. Coming in at number 7 is James Brolin. And you heard me right, James Brolin, the father of Josh Brolin, famous actor from Men in Black 3. Yes, sir. Check out my Men in Black video. But anyway, James Brolin plays an actual significant character in the show, Jeff Winger's father. And since the beginning of the show, Jeff Winger has always been talking about how his father was abusive, or his father left him at birth, and he's kind of paranoid about it and scarred for life, which is a really sad, well, not left him, left him as, during his childhood. And it's a really sad plot line about Jeff. It actually gives Jeff some depth other than just being a jerk most of the time. And it explains a lot of his behavior. But in season four, I'm pretty sure, James Brolin appears as Jeff's dad. And he does a great job at portraying just how much of a jerk his dad was. And it helps you to better understand Jeff as a character. So he plays the part he was given. Coming in at number six is, as I mentioned earlier, John Goodman of many movies fame. Yeah, he's in Monsters, Inc. He's on Oh Brother, Where Art Thou? He's in a lot of movies. Like John Goodman, if you don't know who John Goodman is, trust me, you've seen his face multiple times, like more than Tony Hale. So yeah, you've probably heard his voice numerous times on numerous occasions. His voice is so iconic. But yeah, he plays a villain on this show. He plays like the leader of the air conditioning cult or something like that, something along those lines. And he gets murdered after being a villain and sort of redeems himself as a ghost. So it's a pretty cool storyline, I guess. I like John Goodman as an actor, and I think he does a great job here. Coming in at number five is Brie Larson. And she probably has the biggest role of all the characters on this list, or she appears the most at least, because she plays Abed's girlfriend. I forgot her name. Carol or. That's Captain Marvel. Maybe Rachel or something. But yeah, she plays Abed's girlfriend, and she appears on a couple of a good amount of episodes, like seven or eight. And yeah, she does a good job at playing the character. She's sort of like the female version of Abed, which is why they hit it off so well together. Number four spot is Giancarlo Esposito from The Mandalorian and The Usual Suspects. Yeah, those are the two movies I know him from, or the two things I know him from. But he does a really, really great job in this show. I think he's probably one of the best performances, one of the best actors on this list. He's just such a talented thespian. And he does a really good job on the show playing Pierce's half-brother. I don't even know his name. Don't even ask me to remember his name. But yeah, he gives Pierce some more sympathy and some. He sheds a better light on Pierce by showing that Pierce is, even though a jerk and kind of weird and just politically incorrect all the time, he is a good person deep down within. And he cares deeply for his half brother, even though, well, yeah, especially because their father abused both of them. So he definitely brings out the best in Pierce, which is what any good side character or cameo should do, bring out the best in our main characters. Breaking to our top three is another double, Owen Wilson and Jack Black. And it's mostly Jack Black. But in season one, I think midway through season one, we find out that there's this kid, I don't know his name, this college student guy, Jack Black plays, who's been stalking the group the entire time and feels like he's part of a group, but in reality they didn't notice him the entire time. So the whole episode he's trying to join the group, and at the very end of the episode when they let him into the group after so much fighting and debating, he's like, sorry guys, I applied for another group and they let me in, and apparently Owen Wilson has his own group and he let him in. So it's a really funny cameo. I think these are the two most popular actors on this list, I'd argue. So it's nice to see them so early on in the show before it gained popularity. And I really love the way their roles are, so the roles are portrayed. So yeah, even though Owen Wilson's is probably the most cameo-like on this entire list, he is literally on the episode for like 5 seconds. So a real cameo. And number two is Betty White, and I'm not just doing this because she died recently. Betty White is an absolute legend. I love the way she's portrayed on this show as sort of a villain. She's the anthropology, I'm pretty sure, anthropology teacher at the beginning of season two, but then she goes insane and tries to kill Jeff. So she gets fired. And there's a really funny stinger at the end of the episode where Abed and Troy are doing their Biblioteca rap, but she's doing it with them. And she all of a sudden starts singing lyrics from Africa's to from Toto's Africa.
It's gonna take a lot to get me away from you.
Damn, damn.
There's nothing that 100 men or more could ever do.
Yeah, and it's just really funny. So yeah, Betty White's an absolute legend, as she always is in this show when she appears in season two. And she does spoil Inception. That's funny. She spoils the ending of Inception, which I saw recently. So, yeah, that's nice. But coming in at number one, the number one cameo in this show who's appeared throughout numerous seasons, who's always being referenced, LeVar Burton. LeVar Burton, if you don't know, is the guy from Reading Rainbow, the narrator host guy. And he's also on Star Trek. And he's been referenced so many times throughout this show. He's appeared, I think, like two or three times. He appears during Troy's send-off, which is the most significant time he appears. I think he becomes like Troy's assistant on his trip around the world. So yeah, he definitely brings out some interesting aspects of Troy. Apparently, Troy's really nervous around him, so whenever he's around Troy, like whenever Troy's around him, Troy just doesn't move, and it's really funny. And yeah, he's been referenced since the beginning of the show, basically. And I guess he's one of the show's running gags. And he really, really works in this show. LeVar Burton, I mean, I don't think he's been around. He's been doing much lately. But it's nice to see him in this show. He's great. He's the perfect cameo for this show. Because he just sums up how meta and... that's pretty much it. How meta this show is. So yes, that's my list of the top 10 cameos in Community. Celebrity cameos in Community. JM Comics out.